Hello guys, what's up? This is Sharp talking and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we'll be discussing New Year's 108 Quest Rush event. Yeah, this has a very long name. Let's click on this. This event has exactly 108 different stages. There are plenty of stages. The enemy weaknesses will change between the stages. Sometimes they will repeat stages along the way, but you don't need more than one squad, and I'll tell you why later. So you start from stage number one. And when you reach stage 108, you can repeat the stage just to farm currency and also farm status if you want. The status caps here are pretty nice. It's 1,500 HP, so it's the current max, the same as Barthelemy fight and also the same as Ultra Hard 20 from Maka event. So, let's click on this. You will have to face many enemies. Usually the stages have more enemies than just one. They have like three, four sometimes, so you have to focus more on AoE damage instead of single target damage. The strategy uses Rainbow Rangers formation, and on the top I have Joe. She would just use Sorbet Flambe and then El Nino when needed. And then there is Zeno, a fast attacker as well, and he opens with Noble Cross from Inheritance and then sticks to use like Needles. This is very good because they are attacking before the enemies. And then in the agility position they have the Global X Coppelia. Why? Because she has punishing combo that helps clear waves, and usually she will kill waves by herself. You have two fast attacks, sometimes Coppelia will not be needed, but when she is needed, she will do damage as well. And then we have UDX Matriarch here on the front. She will usually attack on the wave number 2 with Shining Glory, that's also double element, very nice to do damage, and she also buffs and heals, solving all problems we may have. And the last one is Leon. Leon is here more because of his buff. He gives 10% to all characters, plus 5 for Slash and plus 5 for Sun. And, well, you usually be using Imperial Glory on the second wave as well, allowing him to buff everyone so they do more damage, and we can never see more than one turn when farming. So, this is up to stage 108, guys, and this formation worked for me easily. Why? Plenty of dual element attacks, and also 5% more damage to the squad with Joe, 5% more damage to the squad with Matriarch, and again Leon with 10% more, and 5% more for Slash, and 5% more for Sun. So this is like one of the best ones that you can make right now in the game. With that said, you can also use Urpina if you want instead of Matriarch. It will not affect too much. After this, you reach at stage 108, it will not give you enough currency to get everything from the shop. You will still have to farm stage 108 to get more currency, and the event missions will give you plenty of maps. We'll talk more about what you do with the maps later. As you can see, just by clearing the quests, what do we do with these gold maps? Well, actually, we just have to do this other separate event called New Year's 20 Time Only Treasure Cave. You will find 20 different stages here. In every stage, you will spend 10 gold maps. And I already used 3 different quests that will give me 3,000 jewels on total. And once you do the quest, it disappears. So what you can do is just change the order of the rewards, but eventually everyone will get all the rewards if they claim the tower. And one thing that needs to be said is that the tower just changes according to your power. If you are not strong enough, the enemies will be weaker, so this was made so that everyone can get the rewards. After the gems, I suggest you get the gold pieces, and then after that, it's just, well, doesn't matter too much. I think books are still better, and then after that, anything. So with that, you cannot run any of the stages more than once, okay? You do it once, it disappears. So after that, you got all the things you wanted. You have to farm stage 108 to get the currency and purchase things from the shop. Let's talk about strategies then. Well, this stage is different from the other ones. It's a very specific stage. The first wave has two enemies weak to Slash and Moon. And after that, there's a boss called a Gold Dragon that's only weak to Shadow, but a little weak to Pierce, Heat, Cold, and Lightning. So there are some very fast strategies here, but it also takes some time. I will show you the one that is the strongest one, in my opinion, for this event. It may take more than one turn, but I'm showing you how three characters matters in this strategy. You can bring two others that don't really matter. The first one is using Rainbow Rangers. I have Global Axe Rock Bouquet here on the top. She's not inheriting anything. I like to use Psycho Boom. And then I have the newest Madeline skill, Luna Fulgur, but inherited in the UDX It can even be inherited on the first one, because Madeline is only used on the second wave, and the newest version of her has an attack that will stop her to using that on auto, so you have to inherit either on this UDX Madeline or on the other first Madeline. And then I have here Princess Rey. This Princess Rey is super useful here because of Wonder Ohor. This attack here can instant kill between 2 to 3 times, and we have only 2 enemies. Even on the agility position, if you have her on level 50, she will instant kill those targets, allowing all the other characters to attack only on wave 2. If you don't have this Rey, you can bring UDX Death 2.0, but only those two styles will work like this. And then you can bring someone on the Dex position, it can be anyone since it's not important, and then another one in the Love position. With that said, let's go and fight the first wave. Okay, those two enemies here don't have that much HP. I mean, they probably have around 60,000. Don't know if that's too much or not. So that's why it's so good to instant kill them. They are dead. Rey always works because she has a self buff for intelligence. Same thing for UDX Death. And now you have Psycho Boom, and this will debuff the boss 2 times, and it's good because this boss uses elemental attack a lot. Interesting that she attacked before. The damage is pretty nice, but we don't do this in one turn, we just do 3 characters. You have to bring someone that can do enough damage on the Dex position and on the Love position, but it's easy to find someone to do this damage. I think it even Rofus on the Dex position, this enemy is resistant to Blunt and Slash, he will still be able to kill this. Xeno also works pretty fine, he has Eulogy and that skill. It's not that strong here, but still does plenty of damage. We've got agility. Okay, so now I have a variation of this formation. Rey is still on the agility position, then instead of Global X Rock, I have Evelyn, because she has Eutanize. She will use Eutanize on turn 1 against the boss and on turn 2 as well, so the damage will be very good. With Xenon, like I said, Eulogy deals okay damage, and then I inherited Gleam something. It's a single target attack that comes from his S style, I think. And he just keeps using Pierce damage. The good thing is that, well, he's not resisted, but you can use other characters like also Darkie. Darkie can use his skill number 2 times in a row, and that is good enough. Gleam Pierce, the name of the attack. But Xeno is a recent character, and making this just so that people that started the game recently can replicate. All these styles were released on this month. Well, if you don't have Rey, you can bring a lot of Dark Mages and they will work. Here I'm bringing Evelyn and Global X Rock in the front. There is Rouge and also Orluge. If you have the X Death for Rey, they can also work pretty well here. I'm just showing that Animal String is better if you are using Evelyn and Global X Rock in the front to kill the first enemies. With that, let's go. So here, the good thing is that if you have Rock Bouquet and Evelyn on the front, we have an AoE and then a way to kill the remaining enemy with either Evelyn or someone in the back. Doesn't really matter, just increase Orluge PP to 16 for his last skill so he does not use AoE on Gold Dragon. Here's just a combination of the attacks that were remaining. Lightning Crash, and you can also inherit Black Lightning for turn 2 onwards. Does not matter which character attack first or not, as long as you keep Evelyn and Global X Rock in the front, it will work. It takes 2 turns against the boss. Another Eutanize will do a lot of damage. Yeah. And for those without many mages, we can use this one here with Final Emperor on the front. It can also be Urpina. And then increase his Imperial's Word to 13 because I want him to use Double Sun Slash later. But he's resisted against the boss just to clear the first wave for those that don't have any way to do that. And then we have Matriarch. She would just use Shining Glory. She has a very high priority that always goes before Minerva. And Minerva will be used against the boss. And you can bring 2 trainees here. Okay, so you may have to decrease the speed of Minerva, because she may attack before Matriarch. But it's Matriarch agility is higher here. So this is happening, we use a Shining Glory in Imperial's Word, it's what we want. Now we reach the boss, and Emperor will be resisted here, but he helped clear the first wave. It can also be other characters like Leonard or Urpina. It will work fine. But in the end, it's better just Urpina or Leonard because... I mean, Urpina or Emperor, because they will be resisted after that. The boss resists both Slash and Sun. Multitrust is very powerful here, as you see. With that, we have the last strategy. Thank you so much for watching. Hope it helps. If you want to support the channel, there are links here in the description of the video. Hope to see you soon in the next one. Bye.